Greetings. Thank you, Brother Ahmed, for your civility and explanations about what Islam teaches regarding oaths. However, I think there is simply a significant difference between Islam's position and what the prophets said. Your assertion was rather long, brother, so I want to address it in pieces, respectfully, but with critical thinking. You wrote, "Anyway, you're quite wrong here, because when someone swears, he swears by the most precious and glorious thing he could ever think of. One swears by his life because it is most precious to him." To summarize, you wrote, "He swears by the most precious and glorious thing he could ever think of." In logic, brother, when assertions are made and offered as the truth, one way to disprove them is simply by real counterexample. Please do not take offense, but I must offer an irrefutable counterexample, even at the risk it may offend you. In the Quran, Allah swears by everything. Quran 69:38-39. I, meaning Allah, swear by that which you see and that which you do not see. This ayat means your Allah swears by literally and absolutely everything. If you can see it, your Allah swears by it. Remember, brother, this is not me forcing a claim on Allah. Quran 69:38-39 says, "I swear by that which you see and by that which you do not see." I want you to realize, brother, this means Allah swears by literally everything which you may see with your eyes. And that begs a very legitimate question. Can you see a pig, brother? If you can see the pig, brother, Allah swears by the pig. Unfortunately, brother, a pig is not the worst thing a man may see. Can you see a toilet, brother? If you can see a toilet, brother, Allah swears by it. Allah swears by these things according to the Quran. I swear by that which you see and that which you do not see. Allah also swears by unseen things according to the Quran. Ahmed, that means Satan and demons which we cannot see. I ask you, brother, to actually think back to your original excuse for oaths in Islam. But according to you, when someone swears, he swears by the most precious and glorious thing he could ever think of. Do you really think, brother, that excuse explains the observables? Someone swears, he swears by the most precious and glorious thing he could ever think of. Allah swears by everything in existence. Therefore, everything in existence is the most precious and glorious thing Allah could ever think of. Brother, most is a comparison of more than two things. With your definition, brother, everything from stars to pigs is the most precious. Therefore, pigs and Satan and toilets are as precious as Mecca, Muhammad's life, and the stars. Logically, brother, how can anything be any better than anything else when Allah swears by everything? If you want to learn to be logical, brother, any statement you or Muhammad or Allah makes must be weighed and judged by all the other statements they made. To which, brother, your only possible thought can be that Allah never defined why he swears. The excuses by and for Islam, therefore, were created by men. This is why Islam's definition of oaths makes no sense, brother. You must apply every excuse you think supports Islam against every other excuse by Islam. And when you do that, you find that statements for Islam prove other statements for Islam to be false. Allow me to look at the next piece of your explanation. You wrote, "In elections in my country, the president swears by Allah to protect and lead the nation into a better direction, because the major population in my country is made of Muslims." I have no doubt you are sincere, brother. I believe you are sincere in your commitment to your religion. But the leader's oath to Allah is for the people to hear. It is to convince them of his promises. The leader is appealing to your trust in Allah, attempting to leverage it to get you to trust him, your leader. And just let's reason, my friend. Does God need anything? Why didn't he swear by the seven heavens, or why didn't he swear in every verse? Look at it from that perspective, you asked. Brother, it is irrelevant whether the author of the Quran swore in every verse, in most verses, in half the verse, or in only three. An oath is made as assurance to the hearer. That is the only perspective which really matters, brother, because it is correct. An oath is made to assure the one who hears the words. You wrote, when somebody swears, he usually rather always swears by what's considered to be either most great or most precious to him. It could be both. This is then a cultural difference, brother, and honestly, it does not make sense because it accomplishes nothing. If I say, I swear by my cuddly cat, this car is faster than yours, what does that mean or do? An oath is generally not seen to offer at risk the object sworn upon, such as, if your car is faster than mine, you may have my cats. But you did make a statement I really want you to think about. Now, since Allah is the one and only God, there is supposed to be no greater than him. The issue is not the claim Allah is the one and only God. It is that there is supposed to be no greater. Your argument really does not comprehend itself. In one sentence you claim, swears by what's considered to be either most great or most precious to him. Then you write, Allah, there is supposed to be no greater than him. I think you follow a train of logic that you should only swear by Allah. But suddenly you throw out logic so that Allah does not need to follow his own logic. And this is irrational, brother. Allah and the Quran must be judged logically. The prophets demonstrate the Bible's teaching clearly. Genesis 22:16, and said, I swear by myself, declares the Lord. Exodus 32:13, remember your servants, Abraham, Isaac, and Israel, to whom you swore by your own self. Isaiah 45:23, by myself I have sworn. Jeremiah 22:5, but if you do not obey these commands, declares the Lord, I swear by myself. 44:26, but hear the word of the Lord, all you Jews living in Egypt. I swear by my great name, says the Lord. Hebrews 6:13, when God made his promise to Abraham, since there was no one greater for him to swear by, he swore by himself. Islam's position does not make sense with itself. But the Bible's definition of oaths is logically consistent and coherent with itself. God swears only by himself. And when he does, God says, I swear by myself. It makes perfect sense. I encourage you to consider God's consistency and God's logic, brother. Just decide to respect the message of the prophets. You wrote, I would rather understand why my prophet said something than simply following him. Brother, I believe we are examining what your leader said critically and honestly. And so far we have established it does not make sense with its own positions. And I think you place yourself in a dangerous position, brother, holding a man as your prophet. When that one man disagrees with what the one true God revealed so clearly by the prophets. You wrote, "Now when God swears by other than himself, can we really apply the same standard and logic to who is supposed to be the greatest being there is?" I must correct you, brother. God does not. Only Allah of the Quran does. But if you wish to take this position, brother, we can examine it logically without holding God to human standards. Let us judge the story of Allah against what the prophets have revealed. Genesis 22:16, and said, "I swear by myself, declares the Lord." Previously, I showed you 5 instances where Yahweh, God of the Bible, swore by himself. Genesis 22:16, and said, "I swear by myself, declares the Lord." Exodus 32:13, "To whom you swore by your own self." Isaiah 45:23, "By myself I have sworn." Jeremiah 22:5, declares the Lord, "I swear by myself." Jeremiah 44:26, "The word of the Lord, all you Jews living in Egypt, I swear by my great name, says the Lord." There is not one single instance I could find where Yahweh, the God of Abraham, swears by anything other than himself, brother. And Paul, the apostle of God, taught the reason as the Comforter, the Holy Spirit, taught him. When God made his promise to Abraham, since there was no one greater for him to swear by, he swore by himself. So in the Torah and Bible, the God of all set his standard for himself. And the God of all lived by his standard that he set for himself. Then strangely, an Allah appears 600 years later and 800 miles away with no such knowledge. The spirit of the Quran has no awareness of how the God of the Torah and Bible previously behaved. That indicates the two are not the same, brother. The dilemma for Muslims is that your Quran tries to claim they are the same, but clearly they are not. You attempted to answer your own question with, "Of course not, he does not need. Otherwise, you would have seen oaths all over the Quran every verse." But brother, Allah's need to swear does not require him to swear every verse. The latter does not logically follow from the former. The author of the Quran demonstrates his need when he swears in style and form as a man would. You wrote, "God has the right to glorify his creation since he is the greatest there is, but no way he means that the creation is greater than him." But brother, swearing on something does mean it is greater. It means exactly that. And it always means exactly that. We have established an oath is made on the greater thing. You began your message stating this very thing. You wrote, "When someone swears, he swears by the most precious and glorious thing he could ever think of. That must be the greater thing because it is the most." Whether you realize it or not, your argument is changing to say that is not so. That inconsistency exists, brother, because Islam's definition about oaths is incorrect. You wrote, "God has the right to glorify his creation." This is the incorrect definition Islam has created, brother, that when an oath is made on an object, it ascribes glory to the object. An oath is not made to give glory to, or give power to, or add greatness to the object of the oath. An oath is made to borrow glory from or use the power of the object of the oath. It is this borrowed glory that adds power or glory or credibility to the words that the oath affirms. God has the right to glorify His creation. If you want to believe your own argument, you must accept Allah has glorified pigs, toilets, and every unclean and evil thing, seen and unseen. You wrote, instead of accusing me of being blind, why not try to see things from my viewpoint, because I really feel like I've made a very reasonable and considerable point. Brother, I believe you are sincere, and I appreciate your civility and your efforts. However, the truth is not established by either your sincerity or your efforts, or accepting your viewpoint without thought. Brother, I see and I understand your viewpoint. I just do not accept it because it is provably incorrect. Simply stated, because Islam wrongly defines an oath, you accept Allah swearing like a man and see nothing wrong with it. The challenge for you, brother, is to think logically and realize there is a real problem. At least think enough to understand what the prophets wrote. The God of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob does not swear by anything other than himself. He does not swear because nothing is greater than himself. This is God's thinking, brother. This is God's mind on the whole subject. This makes it the absolute, unerring, unfailing truth on the matter. I encourage you to listen to God and understand the message of the prophets, brother. May the Spirit of God open your eyes to the light, your ears to the truth, and your heart to His Son, the Lord Jesus Christ. Amen.